Shabbat Shalom, and welcome to Congregation Beth Israel in Houston, Texas. We're glad that you've joined us on this Shabbat. Shabbat is our day of rest and joy that allows us to create a separation from all that may have occurred during the week. May our prayers, words, and songs help to elevate your soul and bring you comfort, strength, and peace on this day. Please enjoy our service.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Good Shabbos to each of you. As we come into the sanctuary this evening and welcome others who might be arriving a little late due to traffic and congestion on Houston highways, imagine that. We take our places and we set aside the busyness of the week, the challenges that we've had slip away as we appreciate in God's presence through prayer and through song our hope that we can learn from that which we've gone through and enter this day of the Sabbath with expectations for greater rest and joy and strength. And for those who've had a wonderful week, I'm so pleased those joys give us more reasons tonight to say in God's presence and in each other's too, how grateful we are. And we can look forward to more and share our joy with others too. So as we enter this hour of worship, we look forward first to welcome each other and to do so in song.
We continue now with the singing of Lecha Dodi as we welcome the Sabbath. The words can be found on page 20. Yalla la la la, Lecha Dodi.
Habracha Merosh Mi shalom atzeret balam gam besimcha ov soholam toch emune am segulam
prayer book. We turn to page 2 and 3 as we invite Leah Abrams and Brooke Feather to lead us in the blessing over the Sabbath lights.
Candles give light to all behold them. So may we, by our lives, give light to all who behold us. As their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we, in our own day, be among those who kindle light.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kidshanu Bemitzvotav Vetzivanu Lehadlikner Lehadlikner Shel
Blessed are you, Adonai our God, sovereign of the universe, who hallows us with mitzvot, commanding us to kindle the light of Shabbat.
We continue on page 146. As we rise now for our call to worship, Baruch Hu.
I
on page 147, responsively. Adonai, your majesty is proclaimed by the marvels of earth and sky. Sun, moon, and stars testify to your power and wisdom. Day follows day in endless succession.
The years vanish, but your sovereignty endures.
Though all things pass, let not your glory depart from us. Help us to become co-workers with you and endow our fleeting days with abiding worth. Baruch atah Adonai, hamariv aravim. In each age we receive and transmit Torah. At each moment we are addressed by the world.
In each age we are challenged by our ancient teaching. At each moment we stand face to face with truth.
In each age we add our wisdom to that which has gone before. At each moment the knowing heart is filled with wonder.
In each age the children of Torah become its builders and seek to set the world firm in a foundation of truth.
Baruch atah Adonai, Ohev Amo Yisrael.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem, Kevod Malchuto, Le'olam Ha'end. Adonai Elohecha bechol levavcha uvechol nafshecha uvechol meodecha vehayu hadvarim haele asher anochi mitzavecha hayom halevavecha veshinantam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shivtecha b'veitecha uv'lechtecha v'aderech u'shokbecha u'vekumecha u'kshartam lehot al yadecha v'hayu letot avod b'neinecha u'chtavtam amzuzot b'itecha u'visharecha Leman tizkeru, v'asitem et kol mitzvotai, v'item kedoshim le'Eloheichem. Ani Adonai Eloheichem, asher hotzeiti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim, lehiyot lachem le'Elohim. Ani Adonai Eloheichem.
Page 151, responsively. We worship the power that unites the universe, a promise of harmony for all.
As imperfection and evil abound.
Before our eyes, there is a vision of perfection, order, and goodness.
There is evil enough to break the heart, and there is good enough to exalt the soul.
When will redemption come?
When we grant everyone what we claim for ourselves.
Long ago, we escaped the tyranny of Egypt. Our people saw the power of the Most High.
We learned God's presence redeems time and event. So we celebrate this power that makes for freedom.
Bailim Adonai mi kamocha nedar bakodesh nora tehilot o sefele nora tehilot o sefele malchotecha raovanecha bokei ayam lifnei Moshe o Miriam. Adonai imloch le'olam va'ed. Zion. V'ne'emar, kifad Adonai Yaakov, u'ge'alom yad chazak mimeno, baruch atah Adonai, gahal Yisrael.
Ashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu l'shalom, v'amidenu shomenu l'chaim, ufros aleinu sukkat shlomecha. Give us a place to rest, O God. Shelter us in the long, soft evening shadows of your truth. You are true protection and safety. In your presence we find love and acceptance. Watch over us as we go forth. Prepare for us as we return. Spread over us your shelter of peace, over all we love, over our Jerusalem and yours. Baruch atah Adonai, haporei sukkat shalom aleinu, ve'al kol amo Yisrael, ve'al Yerushalayim. In the middle of the page, the people of Israel shall keep Shabbat, observing Shabbat throughout the ages as a covenant for all time. It is a sign for all time between me and the people of Israel. For in 6 days Adonai made heaven and earth, and on the seventh day God ceased from work and was refreshed. We continue on page 155 and 156 as we rise now for Hot Tefillah.
Adonai Sefer Taitiv Tach Ufia Gidei Latecha. Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu, ve'lohei avoteinu ve'imoteinu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, ve'lohei Yaakov, Elohe Sarah, Elohe Rivka, Elohe Rachel, Elohe Leah, Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor Vahanora, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, Vekone Hakol, Vezocher Chaste Avot Veimahot, Umevi Gula Leaf Navenehem, Leman Shemo Beahava, Melech Ozer Umoshia Umagain, Baruch Ata Adonai, Magain Avraham, Vezrat Sarah.
Page 157, responsively. We pray that we might know before whom we stand, the power whose gift is life, who quickens those who've forgotten how to live, having implanted within us an eternal spirit.
We pray for winds to disperse the air of sadness, for rains to make parched hopes rise again.
We pray for love to encompass us, for no reason save that we are human, that we may blossom into persons who have gained power over our own lives.
We pray to stand upright, we fallen, to be healed, we sufferers. We pray to break the bonds that keep us from the world of beauty. We pray to be open to our own true selves. We pray that we may walk in a garden of purpose, in touch with the power of the world.
Praise be the God whose gift is life, whose cleansing rains let parched men and women rise again. Baruch Ata Adonai, Mechaye Hakol. Ata Kadosh Vishimcha Kadosh, Ugedoshim B'chol Yom Yehalaluch Asela. Baruch Ata Adonai Ha'el HaKadosh. You are holy, your name is holy, and those who are holy praise you every day. Blessed are you, Adonai, the holy God. Please be seated. Together on page 160. May these hours of rest and renewal open our hearts to joy and our minds to truth. May all who struggle find rest on this day. May all who suffer find solace. May all who hurt find healing on this day. May all who despair find purpose. May all who hunger find fulfillment on this day. And may we all live in such a way that this day fulfill its promise. Baruch Ata Adonai, Mikadesh HaShabbat. Page 163. Responsively, for the good in us which calls us to a better life, we give thanks.
For the strength to improve the world with our hearts and our hands, we offer praise.
For the desire in us which leads us to work for peace, we are grateful.
For life and nature, harmony and beauty, for the hope of tomorrow, all praise to the source of being.
For all these things, O Sovereign, let your name be forever praised and blessed. O God, our Redeemer and Helper, let all who live affirm you and praise your name in truth. Blessed are you, Adonai. Your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving. Baruch Ata Adonai. As we turn the page and prepare to share our prayer for peace, it is in the wake of so much news in the world that not only for ourselves but for others who are touched by our life, that we share in English and then in song our greatest hope for enduring peace together. Grant us peace, your most precious gift, O eternal source of peace. And give us the will to proclaim its message to all the peoples of the earth. Bless our country as a safeguard of peace, its advocate among the nations. May contentment reign within our borders, health and happiness within our homes. Strengthen the bonds of friendship and fellowship among all the inhabitants of our world. Plant virtue in every soul, and may the love of your name hallow every home and every heart. Praised are you, Adonai, who blesses your people with peace. Baruch Ata Adonai, HaMevarech Et Amo Yisrael, Ba'Shalom.
Shalom Rav, Al Yisrael.
Take a moment now for silent prayer. Meaningful prayers set to beautiful music help all of us feel what we've come here to feel tonight. Renewed hope that we can overcome any challenges physically, emotionally, or spiritually. but there are those in our congregational family and circle of friends who need our prayers too, for their health, for their well-being. And so tonight, especially, we are thinking of Katie Waldman, Sam Bluestein, Susan Bluestein, Karen Rockland, Mary Harbour, Phyllis Harris, Rena Rauch. For them and for all who are dear to us, we share a Misha Berach, a prayer for health and well-being. The words can be found in the backside of your Friday night guide. Please join us.
Sheberach avoteinu, Abraham, Yitzchak, v'Yaakov. Sheberach imoteinu, Sarah, Riv, Kalea, v'Rachel.
In the cycle of Torah reading, we find ourselves in the book of Exodus, not an unfamiliar place to any of us. But the turning point in the story in Exodus, which is so powerful, is the one that we retell in the Passover story in Haggadah every year. But sometimes we pass by too quickly what Moses stood still to observe, the burning bush. And the bush that burned unconsumed caught the attention of the rabbis too. Because as much as God was always seen, observed, and experienced on high, on the mountain, somewhere in the distance, here God appeared to Moses in that lowly thorn bush. And so the rabbis, in their own interpretation, we call the Midrash, asked the question, why did God appear in a lowly thorn bush? You know, just as an aside, we might imagine that even sitting in our sanctuary tonight, the architects had the idea that our holiness would be on high, a tall bima, an ark that would lift our chin to see all that was high and holy above us. Only in recent years did we even bring the stairs a little lower so that I might come here and stand before you rather than on high. So Rabbi Joshua ben Karcha in the Midrash, in a rabbinic interpretation, raised the question and answered it, thankfully. He said that a non-Jewish, or perhaps even a Jewish, heathen, a non-believer, came to and asked the question, why did God appear in a lowly thorn bush? And the rabbi answered him and said, had you asked why God appeared in a sycamore tree or a carob tree, if that's where God had shown up, you would have still doubted God's appearance there. But not to answer the question is not good either. So I'll tell you why. And the rabbi said, God appeared in a lowly thorn bush because that if God could appear there, then God could appear anywhere. Now, why did the rabbi pick a sycamore tree and a carob tree to make a comparison? Because a sycamore tree is beautiful. We might even put one in our yard. And a carob tree, if you know anything about carob, grows a slender pod. They grow well in the Middle East. And it's a substitute for chocolate, if you believe that. There's really no substitute for real chocolate. But if a non-believer were to come and say God appeared there, then surely wouldn't believe and care to understand why God would appear in such a lowly place. But now that we understand that God could appear there and therefore anywhere, we can also appreciate what we ourselves might come to understand about God too. Because you see, very often on a night like this, on the Sabbath, when we celebrate God's presence in our life and give thanks to God for all God's gifts, and celebrate the nachas, the real joy of two bat mitzvah girls, there's no question among us that we feel grateful. We might even say, thank God. And when we say, thank God, even if we're not believers, we are imagining something separate, something larger than ourselves, that helps us to enter this time and arrive at this place. How many of you have been on a magnificent mountain hiking in the midst of summer, perhaps in Colorado, or on the seashore enjoying the beautiful views and the waves, and you say, oh, my God. That's a prayer. That's a way of saying, I had nothing to do with those waves. I had nothing to do with those beautiful trees and those high mountains. Something beyond myself was a part of the acts of nature that created it. So why is it that when we enter a place that isn't so beautiful, it isn't so great, that we suddenly find ourselves saying, why did God abandon me? A low place, a time of mourning, a time of great loss. I remember visiting someone in the hospital and he said to me, Rabbi, why did God abandon me? I couldn't take the moment and teach him a text and a midrash. He was in no mood for that. But I did draw on its meaning to share with him that God is present in all the times of our life, not only in the high moments when it's so obvious and clear, but also in the moments when it's so challenging to understand. And so we discover through the rabbi's interpretation and throughout the history of Jewish theology that God isn't a king, an autocrat, a monarch of sorts, but rather God is more like an unconditionally loving parent who lifts us up when we're down, helps us find the courage within ourselves when we feel terribly weak, hopeful when we feel despair, and especially in moments of goodness and joy, to help us feel especially grateful for all that we've come to know. That fits with our Jewish and our modern interpretation of a world in which we not only count on God's presence in our life, but also God counts on our deeds to make a difference where we need to. So I mention this text because we live in a complicated world. You know that. You don't need me to tell you that the news today is so confounding that whether you listen to the news just as you entered here tonight, the impeachment trial, the Middle East, polarization going on between all of us in this country, anti-Semitism on the rise, some of us would rather go home and close the door and pull the shades and be done. But our tradition urges us to see that even in the places where we feel confounded, we find in God's presence a hopefulness that actually within us is all that we need. And so when we feel hopeless, we find that we have something to do about it, not only to pray, but actually in Judaism, a religion of action, something to do. And so we're encouraged, even in the midst of rising anti-Semitism, to demonstrate what is the joy of Judaism, what is positive about being Jewish, the ethics, the morality, the hope for tomorrow, and to demonstrate it, to live it, and to teach it. And even in the midst of rancor in the Senate and the House, to believe that in a democratic country, we still have the opportunity and the privilege to vote. And I don't care how you choose to vote, I would only say, as a rabbi can only say from the pulpit, vote and make a difference. And pray as if everything depends on heaven, but do as if everything depends on you. And then we're not left without power, we're not left without will, or even hope. Because in a world of such complexity, it has always been the Jewish community, in partnership with other faith communities, to believe that God's presence is not something far and away from us, but actually so close that we don't have to look up to the mountain, we can look down to our feet. And certainly in the midst of the Israelites' troubles and tribulations in Egypt, Moses was despondent and down and wondering where help would come from. He wasn't looking up, he was looking down. But I will tell you what I was also taught. If you ever find yourself despairing and crying over what can't be recovered and can't be repaired, look up. Physiologically, you cannot cry if you are looking up. I'm not going to tell you to try it, but if ever happens to you, look up. And so as this week unfolds in front of us after Shabbat ends, let's say instead of just thank God, or good God, or oh my God, maybe we can also say, God willing, I can find within myself what needs to be done to make a difference in the world where I live and where others are touched by my life. And I can say to that, Ken Yehi Ratzon, may it be God's will that we find in our own hands and hearts and those who join us all that we can muster to make a positive difference in the world tomorrow. Amen. Please rise. As we take our places before the Holy Ark at this high place, we discover that the beauty and the gifts of God's presence in our life have enabled us to appreciate the long way that we have come, not the circuitous route that the Israelites took from Egypt to the Promised Land, but the deliberate and meaningful steps that generations have taken to provide Torah and its teachings for the next generation. What a privilege it is now to pass the Torah and its teachings from great grandparents, to parents, to children.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adonainu, Kadosh Shemo.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adonainu, Kadosh Shemo.
In our prayer book, we turn now to the bottom of page 282 and 287 as we join in Aleinu.
Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon ha'kol, l'tet g'dula l'yotzer b'reishit, shelo asanu kiyuye ha'ratzot, velo samanu kimishpachot adama, shelo samchalkenu kahem, vegor aleinu kechol amonam, Vanachnu korim umishtachavim umodim lifnei melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu v'nemar v'yadonai lemelech al kol haaretz b'yom ha'hu b'yom ha'hu yeh Adonai echad, uv shemo echad.
In our prayer book, we turn now to page 294. As we do, we call to heart and mind those dear ones who departed this earth and entered the peace of life eternal. It's our custom in the sanctuary as well in the chapel to invite you, if you wish, to stand at your seat as the name of your loved one is called. Afterwards, all of us will rise to honor the memory of our loved ones as we recite Kaddish. And now we remember lovingly Mary Berg, Pearl Bernstein, Eugene Blackschlager, Elizabeth Bach, Michael Borovic, Murray Braverman, Alexander Brodsky, Cecilia Brodsky, Milton Buckman, Leonard Burke, Joel Kamhai, Irving Kaplan, Sigmund Chernik, Gerson Cohen, Molly Croft, Sandra Daly, Jay Davis, Rose DeVos, Helen Diamond, Milton Ellish, Bryson Engel, Hannah Edelson, Cora Fetterman, Herbert Freypart, Brian Friedman, Newton Friedman, Dorothy Glazer, Ralph Golub, Louis Good Jr., Grace Grenader, Maury Hammett, Ronald Harwood, Ruth Hoff, Frank Holtzman, Reba Kanner, Irvin Kaplan, Gerald Katz, Julius Katz, Peggy Katz, Ronald Katz, Joseph Kirschbaum, Frank Kretzer, Sarah Landy, Kathy Lerner, Lawrence Levy, Evelyn Marshall, Joan Joy McCarthy, Bob Meisel, Lucille Meyer, Pearl Michaels, Bessie Nackless, Shirley Ostro, Leon Pellows, Miriam Rackeson, Hattie Reeder, Leonard Resnick, Louis Robin, William Rose, Dorothy Rosenberg, Maurice Rosenberg, Pearl Rosenberg, Rose Rosenfield, Daniel Schlanger, Simone Schwartz, Julius Seligman Jr., Saul Shaler, Phyllis Shane, Alexander Stoffman, Ruth Simon, Edith Smoke, Joseph Sofer, Michael Spillane, Margaret Steinberger, Melvin Steiner, Eric Sewell, Sonny Sewell, Tima Stolper, Lillian Topp, Marion Van Gelder, Ida Verman, E.L. Wagner, Morris Weisblum, Carolyn Warwick, Raphael Weissman, Heinz Weisenstein, Esther Weisskopf, Bertha Wellen, Jessard Wish, Charles Wolfe, Marjorie Zeidman. In their memory and honor, let us all rise as we join in reciting the words of Mourner's Kaddish. Yit gadal v'yit kadash shmei rabah, v'yama divrach yirute v'yamlich malchute, v'chayechon v'yamechon v'chayeducho beit Yisrael, v'agalav v'izman kari v'imru amen. Yehesh me rabba mevorach le'alam olam me'amaya. Yidbarach v'yishtabach v'yidbar v'yitramam v'yitnaseh. V'yidadar v'yitaleh v'yitalal shmeid gurusha b'richu. Le'alam min kol b'irchata v'shirata. Tush b'chata v'nechamata. Damiram b'yama v'imru amen. Yehesh lama rabba min shemaya. V'chaim ma'alenu v'al kol Yisrael b'imru amen. Ose shalom b'mromav, hu yase shalom. Alenu v'al kol Yisrael b'imru amen. May the source of peace send peace to those who mourn and comfort to all the bereaved among us, as together we say, Amen. Day, the day in which we give thanks to God for the gifts of our life. Our benot mitzvah will lead us, and we can join them on page 5.
The heaven and the earth were finished in all their array. On the seventh day, God finished the work that God had been doing. And God ceased on the seventh day from all the work that God had done. And God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy, because on it, God ceased from all the work of creation that God had done.
Praise to you, Adonai our God, sovereign of the universe, creator of the fruit of the vine. Praise to you, Adonai our God, sovereign of the universe, who finding favor with us, sanctified us with mitzvot. In love and favor, you made the holy Shabbat our heritage as a reminder of the work of creation. As first among our sacred days, it recalls the Exodus from Egypt. You chose us and set us apart from the peoples. In love and favor, you have given us your holy Shabbat as an inheritance. Praise to you, Adonai, who sanctifies Shabbat.
We therefore raise the cup in thanksgiving. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei peri hagafen. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kishanu mitzvotav veratzav alanu, veshabbat kodesho be'ahava uvratzo.
Shabbat Shalom. My name is Roslyn Hyken, and I have the privilege of serving as Vice President of Beth Israel's Board of Trustees. On behalf of the congregation, we extend a mazel tov to the families of Dylan Abrams and Lily Feather, who are celebrating their benot mitzvah this Shabbat. Cantor Trumpeter is currently under the weather and is celebrating Shabbat at home. Next week, our new member Shabbat, where all new members of our congregation will be invited to the Bima for a special blessing, followed by a congregational oneg in their honor. On Sunday morning and Monday evening, we will welcome published authors from our congregational community who will speak on their newly published books. Details for when Mark Roseberg, Dr. Miriam Friedman, Dr. Bard Schachtel and Rabbi Barry Blocker speaking are listed in your Friday night guide. The election of the World Zionist Congress is now open to everybody. This is our chance to appoint delegates who will carry out our reformed Jewish values in Israel, like equality and religious pluralism. Voting will continue through March 11th, and laptops have been set up in the Wolf Tumen Hall to assist you after services. If you have any questions, please contact our congregational captain, Stanley Horn. Registration for both the congregation's Israel trip in June and the APAC policy conference in Washington in March are still ongoing. If you are interested in learning about these opportunities, please contact David Scott. After services, Leslie Margolis, Doug Aaron, and I look forward to welcoming all members and guests to Congregation Beth Israel on behalf of our Board of Trustees. Please join us for an oneg in the Wolf Tumen Hall. Shabbat Shalom.
And thank you to Rabbi Scott for being Cantor Scott tonight. And we look forward to having Cantor Trumpeter return when she feels better. And now we invite you to join us in our closing song. We'll sing Adon Olam. The words can be found on page 321. Please rise and join us. Closing benediction, please remain in your places for just a moment so that Rabbi Scott and I may exit the sanctuary first. We look forward to greeting you in the Onik Shabbat. Eloheinu ve'elohe avoteinu ve'imoteinu, our God and God of our ancestors, in the midst of a world filled with brokenness, we look forward to your presence to guide us to a world of unity. May we, with our prayers and our deeds, build a world of greater peace for us and all your children everywhere. Amen. Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you for being a part of our community on this Shabbat. I hope that you enjoyed our service and your soul is uplifted with strength and peace to last you into the coming week. Please know that I, as well as the rest of our clergy team, are available to you with any questions you may have about our sacred congregation. Thank you for joining us. Shabbat Shalom.